YouTube, and welcome to another edition of Gear Wars. Today we're talking about bass clarinet cases. Now, if you've bought a bass clarinet, it probably came with a case, unless you bought it off the back of a truck. But, you know, if you bought a student bass clarinet, oftentimes those cases are total crap, because that's where the manufacturers cut corners to make the price point low. Now, if you bought maybe a used bass clarinet, it may come with a case that's really old and in need of replacement. Even if you bought a brand new bass clarinet, it may come with a case that is not perfect for your situation. If you need to travel, if you need to put several other instruments in it, usually bass clarinet cases just carry a bass clarinet. What I've done is picked up 6 different aftermarket bass clarinet cases that you can get, and I'm going to compare them all in terms of their weight. How much do they weigh empty? Their size? Will it fit into an overhead bin of an airplane? Some of the special features they have. Some of them are waterproof, some of them hold several different instruments. The amount of storage space they have, and how comfortable they are to schlep around. So without further ado, let's get started. To begin with, let's introduce the cases. On the very left is a BAM Trekking bass clarinet case. This case is probably the most common that I've seen in rehearsals and with students and on people's backs in the subway. To its right here is the Reed and Squeak bass clarinet case. This bass clarinet case is handmade in London, as are the following two. This is a Wiseman Type A bass clarinet case, which is leather and wood. This is the Wiseman carbon fiber bass clarinet case. This one is beat up because it's mine, and I've had it for a while. Over here is the BAM High Tech bass clarinet case. This is fairly recent, probably about 3 or 4 years old. And on the very bottom is the Lomax Humidipro bass clarinet case. So now that we see what they all are, let's compare them. First up, we have the BAM Trekking bass clarinet case. Now, this is not one of the more compact bass clarinet cases of the bunch. In fact, it's one of the bulkier ones. And what that means for you is if you want to put this on an overhead of your airplane, it will only fit in some of the larger or the mid-sized airplane overheads. It will not fit in a Bombardier or Embraer jet. And those are the jets, if you don't know those names, those are the ones where you have 2 seats in 1 seat, or 2 seats in 2 seats, and small overhead bins. So what that means is simply, it's not going to fit overhead, so you're going to have to beg the flight attendants to put it in the coat closet, which they may or may not do, and if they don't, you have to put it underneath the plane. So that's something for you to think about. So this bass clarinet case is made of a water-resistant Cordura fabric. On the outside of the bass clarinet case, we have a pouch for reeds. It has an external pouch here, which can hold music, or if you open it up even larger, it will hold an external double clarinet case. You slide it right in there. Now, as it goes in, it kind of is a little bit loose, but it fits very nicely, and it allows you to carry both your clarinet and your bass clarinet at the same time. You do not have to buy another clarinet double case if you already own one, so that's kind of a nice feature. Now, the case itself opens with 2 zippers, and I like the fact that the zippers have a red thread on them because it allows you to see that it's closed before you pick the clarinet up. Now, I actually, like I said, owned this case, and one time I was rushing out of rehearsal, I had forgotten to zip it closed, and the bass clarinet case opened and my bass clarinet fell out of it. So it's nice that they've added these red threads so that you can actually see that the instrument is closed. So anyway, it unzips, and inside is our bass clarinet. Now, one of the things that you need to pay attention to as you're looking at bass clarinet cases is how well does it immobilize the bass clarinet. You do not want the bass clarinet to jiggle around inside the case while the case is being worn or carried. The more it's immobilized, the less the keys will bump against the sides and the longer your clarinet will stay in adjustment. Super important. So right now we have a spot for your neck, 1 mouthpiece, your bell. There is not a spot for the peg, so you kind of have to like leave it here or maybe put it underneath the bottom joint here, but then it would jiggle and bounce against the wood. Not quite sure what I'm supposed to do with that. It has a spot for accessories as well. Now, immobilized, the top joint is really, it's not going to move at all. The bottom joint, however, does have room to jiggle, so you might want to put something down here, maybe another piece of foam to keep it so that the bass clarinet bottom joint doesn't move around too much. That's really, really important. Another interesting feature of this case is that it actually has a raincoat attached to it. You can take this out of the back zipper and it will pull down over the bass clarinet case in its entirety to keep it from getting wet, which is kind of nice because this Cordura fabric, while water resistant, will actually absorb some water. So it's nice that it comes with a built-in raincoat. Below that is an area where 2 shoulder straps, or I should say backpack straps, live. And it allows you to carry it like a backpack.
Is it comfortable?
It's pretty comfortable.
It's pretty comfortable. How's it feel on your shoulders?
It's okay.
Here we have the newest version of the BAM high-tech bass clarinet case. The earlier version was, it had a carbon fiber look and it was shiny. Here, this is a little bit more texturized and rubberized, and I think the good thing about that is that it will not show scratches as much as the carbon fiber look version would. This case will fit in any airplane overhead. A couple of other features of the case before we get inside. Here is a pouch that you can put, you know, your cell phone or some keys in. Outside here is a special padded music case, or if you spend an extra $120, it comes with this zippered B-flat and A double case. It has room for both B-flat and A. Top joints are here. It holds three barrels, it looks like, two mouthpieces, and some cork grease. It's very, very soft velvet, and it looks like it looks to be a pretty decent case for $110. So, it slides right in, and this is a kind of a rubberized, it's got a little bit of pull to it, sort of little bit of elasticity, and this slides right over the outside of this double case. Zip's closed, and you're good to go. Now, with this case inside, this will not fit in overheads of a lot of the smaller planes. It should fit in the medium and the larger planes, but that's okay, because you can always get it on the plane and take the clarinet out, slip it under the seat in front of you, and then again, this will fit in the overhead. On the back side of this case, there's a couple features. It's got a couple of straps right here, so to carry it, with some neoprene cushioning. And this is a special feature which I'd like to point out. This is a memory foam cushion for the small of your back, so that when you're carrying it, this will keep the instrument from kind of banging against you. And it's pretty darn comfortable. So it's a pillow material. It's pretty cool. All right, let's get inside. Okay, so to open the case, one thing I want to point out is that because it has this back pad, it doesn't sit flat on the ground, but I suppose if you take that back pad off, it would. There are two combination locks here and here that flip open like so. They're pretty slick. A central latch right here. Once the case is open, it's a very compact design. Here we have all of the joints of the instrument completely immobilized. They don't move at all. They're just shoved right in there. The bell and the neck go here, and the mouthpiece is inside this pouch like so. This pouch itself is large enough to accommodate some reeds and a swab, but not much else. One of the nice features here about this this case is that it actually has a large ball-shaped slot, which is, if you have a buffet bass clarinet, they come with that ball at the base of the peg, that rubber ball, so that would, there's actually room for that to fit here. I don't have a buffet, so this kind of slides in like so. More likely than not, I would take this because it doesn't have the ball, and I would slip it underneath this pouch and stick the pouch on top of it so that it doesn't jiggle around and bounce into the instrument at all. So that is the inside of the BAM case. Let's put it on Catherine.
Okay, so this case is pretty comfortable. I really like the little pad that's on the back. That's a definite plus, because it goes from about here all the way down to your butt. So if you're walking, it's going to be more comfortable. The straps are pretty good. I'd like a little bit more padding here, but this is nice.
I had to try this myself just to see what this back cushion thing is all about. I have to say, it is super, super awesome. The top padding here, though, is a little bit lacking for me, just because I'm expecting a little more than just the neoprene that exists here. So I agree with Catherine that I would like for there to be more padding. But damn, is this comfortable. Next up, we have the Wiseman Type A bass clarinet case. Now, there's a Type B or a Series B bass clarinet case that is about 10 centimeters longer on this side. That's about the only difference, is the amount of storage that it has on the inside. I own this particular one. It is a Type A. It comes with an external pouch for, gosh, just all sorts of things. This could be for mace or pepper spray. Here's where you can store your rolling papers. No, actually, I have no idea what this is for, and I never use it. So I'll take that off. But it does come with the bass clarinet case. It comes with this nice leather pouch. It's actually a really nice pouch. It also comes with an oversized music pouch that wraps around the outside of the bass clarinet. Now, the case is entirely wrapped in leather, and the inside, I believe, is kind of a curved plywood. It is heavy, but it will definitely fit in every single airline compartment of any size. I've tried it, it works. On the other side, we have two padded shoulder straps. They're both leather, and there's a couple different ways that you can hook them on here. They come off with a buckle. So if you don't want them on, you can take them off. If you do and want them sort of set up differently, you can do that. It's open with Velcro. Now, originally I was like worried about the fact that, you know, the Velcro would wear out and the case would accidentally open. This case is like 10 or 12 years old. It has never opened. So it opens entirely with Velcro. That's the only mechanism. And inside we have the bass clarinet strapped in. But what I asked Howard to do, and this is not how he normally makes these cases, so this is a little bit customized, is that the instrument joints themselves are elevated and suspended off the bottom of the case and the sides of the case, so none of the keys actually touch anything. How that's important is the keys, if they don't touch anything, they don't get jiggled around and go out of adjustment. So I asked him to do this, and it's really kept my instrument from having to go to the shop as often because it's totally immobilized in here. Over here on this side is this really odd compartment. I'm not quite sure why he made it this way, for the neck. And over on this side is where you store your mouthpiece. On the other side is a velvet cushion, which folds open. And what it allows you to do is it gives you access, obviously, to the bell. But then there's this multi-use area here. Now, you know, you can throw reeds in here. You can throw your swab in here. You can throw basically anything you want in here. What's kind of interesting about this part is that there's two strips of Velcro here. And he gives you a set of dividers that will allow you to change how this middle section is split up. And that's useful when you want to put something like a clarinet in here. So you can put your clarinet in and put a holder in right like this to keep the clarinet from moving. And then you can maybe throw your bottom or your top joint in here, throw your mouthpiece over there. And then you've got something that keeps your clarinet and your bass clarinet on your back in the same size space. So I love the fact that it's modular that way, and I can decide to take a clarinet or not take a clarinet. I could throw an iwi in here. It's pretty slick that way, and the whole thing closes up just with a little bit of Velcro, and we're good to go.
So given my size, the shoulder pads are not actually on my shoulders. They're in my armpits.
Isn't that comfortable?
It's awesome. Yeah,
okay, so if you turn around, how does it feel in terms of like this tube on your back? Does it feel comfortable?
It's okay. It's not super comfortable because you really feel it, you know, just up and down your back.
Here we have the Wiseman carbon fiber bass clarinet case. Now this is by far the lightest case of the bunch. The carbon fiber shell is extremely durable, though as you can see it does scratch a little bit, but then I'm not especially careful with it. It is a case after all. It comes with the same pouch, which again, I don't use. And it also comes, like the other Wiseman case, with an extra large music pouch, which I also don't use because I play everything from memory. Instead of Velcro, it opens with these two twist latches, which open up, and then the shell opens up like so. So this is a slightly different interior design than the other case. It still has the velvet touches around the inside of it, but the bass clarinet itself barely touches any of it. When you lift this up here, you can see, again, I asked Howard to make the instrument completely immobilized and also lifted off the bottom of the case so I can stick my hand underneath it if I want to on both joints. None of the keys touch anything, which is, again, it keeps the instrument in much better playing order because the keys don't get jostled around while you're carrying the case. Inside this little pouch right here is the neck, which does kind of float around a little bit, but, you know, the neck is pretty durable. On this side is the bell, and under here is where you put your mouthpiece, like so. Inside this pouch here is where I have my peg for the bass clarinet, and I can put all of my reeds and things inside here. This space is for rent. I have no idea what that's good for, but I do shove stuff in there occasionally, like a swab. Now this here is my iwi, and I had this case specifically made to hold an iwi. It does not hold a clarinet. The nice thing that you should know is that Howard Wiseman will customize this case for you if you have two specific instruments you want to carry. If you want to carry, you know, a bass clarinet and two clarinets, or a bass clarinet and an E-flat, or a bass clarinet and a trumpet, he can figure out a way of making this case work for you because he builds these all by hand. So it fits in all overhead compartments, and it doesn't matter what airplane you take it into, it's not a problem. Tell us, does this feel significantly lighter?
Yeah, it's definitely lighter than the other one. The straps are in a better location. They're actually useful here.
Here we have the Reed and Squeak bass clarinet case. This case is made out of a coated polyester fabric. It's got some kind of a harder material underneath it. It doesn't feel like it's super strong, but it definitely feels hard enough. It's very similar to the BAM trekking case. This case is made in London. It has an outside zipper pouch, but this zipper pouch is actually not large enough to put music inside, because this is sewn underneath. So this is not for music, but I suppose you could put other things like reeds or a strap or your swabs in there. On the back side, it has no backpack strap, so that's something to take note of. It does, however, have what they call a subway strap up here, which allows you to hold the bass clarinet upright. It does not have a handle on the very top. It's open with two zippers, like so, and when you open the case up, you get nothing because there's this flap here. Now let's talk about this area. This flap could also be used as music storage if your music is small enough. If you have a normal book, the book itself will fold or curl up a little bit underneath, so it doesn't really fit book-sized things, but then again, I suppose if you needed to, you could put your music underneath like so. Now let's take a look at the inside of this reed and squeak case. Everything in here is a foam pillow, okay? So everything in here is soft and it's got a velvet coating to it. Now what's kind of interesting about the way they've designed this is that it's totally modular. These pads, these foam pads here, you can use them or not. I choose to use them because it just, again, it immobilizes the instrument all that much more from jiggling around inside the case. But even without it, it's pretty solid. Once these two are out, let me take out this bottom joint just to show you. There is another pillow below it you can use or not, and it's got these when I say pillow, this is a pillow, but it's got a hard kind of box on the inside of it. It sounds like it's sort of hard foam. And the use of these is so that you, with a different sized instrument, even though there are a lot of low C bass clarinets and they're basically the same, there's slight differences in the way the keys work and slight differences in how, you know, the length of the joint, actually. So you have an option to have a larger or a smaller one of these pillows in here just to immobilize that joint. Same thing goes for this joint as well. Inside here, there is a pillow below it you can use or not, and it's got this pillow on this side right here as well. And again, the whole instrument case is modular. I could choose to put my bell over here if I wanted to. The whole thing, I just decided how I wanted to lay the case out. So having this shoved in here, it keeps the bass clarinet bell immobilized, and then there are pouches for all of the other different parts. So here's a pouch for the neck that I put in here, and a mouthpiece and a second mouthpiece if I wanted to, and in the bottom here is my peg. Now something that's kind of interesting to think about is how you want to use this middle space. Now you could use this middle space to put your top joint if you wanted to, or it's just about the right size to have a clarinet fit. The thing I don't quite like about it is that it's pressing down the keys, but it definitely fits your clarinet, and you could even put one of these pillows on top of it if you wanted. So that's what's kind of interesting, is it's very modular. It definitely would fit an E-flat clarinet, and in my case, it fits my EWI, my electronic wind instrument, quite perfectly. And then if you have your mouthpiece and things like that, they can all fit inside these pouches like so. So this is the Reed and Squeak bass clarinet case. Last but not least, we have the Lomax Classic Humidipro bass clarinet B-flat and A triple case. I don't think I need to say this, but this will not fit in any airplane overhead, period. It is just too large. It won't fit in anything. Fortunately, though, Mike Lomax buys the outer shell of these cases from a company called Pelican. Pelican makes cases of all different sizes and shapes for the military. You can run a tank over this case. I use a case similar to this to take all of my electronic gear to concerts. So this is a really, really rock solid, very strong case. It's actually also 100% waterproof. That said, it is extremely heavy. Fortunately though, it has wheels on the back of it. So these wheels, which are pretty free, they're ball bearing wheels, allow you to roll the case, which is a good thing because, like I said, it's crazy heavy. So getting into this case is done by way of four very heavy duty latches. And we open the case up, and on the top here, let me pull this in, is more of a cushiony foam. This is more open-celled foam with a velvet top. The foam is held in by Velcro, and they say that you can put music and slip it in behind here, but I don't see that as being an especially practical solution. I don't think I would do that. Now, on the bottom half is laser-cut closed-cell foam. This is very dense foam, so it doesn't squeeze. It holds its shape. And each one of these is cut specifically for the instrument, and the instrument is completely, completely immobilized in here, all of them. They do not jiggle at all. Over here is space for a neck. Now, this is not made for my neck. This is a Selmer neck, and some of the buffet necks come up a little bit more, they're not as wide, so this would fit better, but as it sits here, it will not fit, so I have to bend this around like that. Not especially happy about that, but So it is. There's room for one bass clarinet mouthpiece and two clarinet mouthpieces. There seems to be an oversight. There isn't really a place for the peg, so I've got it kind of shoved in there. Over on this side, we have room for four barrels. Over here is a pretty cool feature. This is a hygrometer, and what a hygrometer does is it shows you the humidity, and in this case, the temperature of the inside of the case. Now, this case is called the Humidipro bass clarinet case, so it has something to do with humidity. As I mentioned, there's a rubber gasket here, and when the case is closed, it is waterproof. And so the inside of the bass clarinet case, the climate is stabilized by having, dun dun dun, let me pull this out, three places where Lomax has put these special pouches. Now these are sold by Diodario. It's a two-way humidification system. These are made for guitars, but you can also buy these from Boveda. And what these do is two-way. It means that if the inside of the case gets not humid enough, this will let humidity out. And if it becomes too humid, it will take some of the humidity and put it inside the pouch. These things actually work. And Lomax has put three of them inside the bass clarinet case to regulate the humidity. And you can check the humidity with this hygrometer. That's pretty cool. So this is the Lomax Humidipro bass clarinet case. And it is built like a brick shit house. And so there you have it. Now, as you've seen, each of these cases has some pretty unique features, which makes it difficult for me to recommend the best case for every purpose, because, you know, it depends on what you're doing with the case, which one of these is best for you. So let's just sort of take them one by one. The bottom here, this is the Lomax Humidipro bass clarinet, and this would be perfect if you were a touring musician and you had to put your instruments underneath the bus or a train or an airplane, because this thing is built like a tank, and apparently you could run a tank over it. If you have a tank, go ahead and try running over it. I don't have one handy, or else I might have done that. But it is climate controlled on the inside, and it is just super, super solid. So if that sounds like you, this is the case for you, okay? Moving over to, let's go to the Wiseman for a second. This carbon fiber Wiseman case is my favorite case. It is by far the lightest of the bunch, because carbon fiber is very strong but very, very light. Wiseman will customize it for you like he did for me with an iwi, but you could have him probably put a soprano sax in there, or you could have him make it so that two clarinets and a bass clarinet could fit in there. It's a terrific, terrific case, but it's also by far the most expensive case of the bunch. So, you know, the more you spend, the less it weighs. That's often the way it works, but that's the Wiseman carbon fiber. I love, love, love this case. To the left of that is the other Wiseman case I have. Now again, this is leather, and it doesn't show scuffs like this one does, but it's a little bit heavier, it's about half the price, but again, Wiseman will customize the inside of it for you. So if you aren't worried about getting the lightest case money can buy, this Wiseman case is terrific, terrific case. It is, like I said, it's about half again heavier. Over here to the far right is the BAM high-tech bass clarinet case. This has some unique features in that it comes with a matched, or you can, I should say, you can buy a matched B-flat and A double case for it, and that fits in perfectly in this front pouch. It is small enough without the clarinet in it to fit in an overhead. It's really nice, scuff resistant, and I really love the back cushion on this case. I like this case an awful lot. It's also the shortest, pretty much, of the bunch. On the far left is the other BAM trekking case. Now, this is the bulkiest case of the bunch. It is the second least expensive case, and it's probably my least favorite of the bunch. But if you have a double case or a single case already and you don't want to have to spend another $100 for one of these, you can put your double case or your single case in that front pouch, and it will fit, most likely. So that makes it really good for people who don't want to buy another case, want a good, solid, very sturdy, and very protective bass clarinet case, and not spend a ton of money. And then the last bass clarinet case, which is the Reed & Squeak, is the lowest cost, but I have to say it is you get the most bang for your buck with this case by far. It's modular on the inside, it's not extremely heavy, it's one of the lighter cases of the bunch. It's configurable the way you need to. You could put a bass clarinet in there, or you could probably put two clarinets in there if you needed to, or you could even put an alto clarinet in there if you needed to. It's very, very modular that way. The downside of it, of course, is it doesn't have straps, you can't carry it like a backpack, And the music pouch on the front really isn't a music pouch. Music doesn't fit in it, so it's really more of an accessories pouch. So, but in terms of for the money, the Reed & Squeak case is a terrific, terrific value. So like you can see here, it really depends on what you want to do. If you want lightweight, if you want inexpensive, if you want tank-proof, you know which ones you want to check out. But I certainly hope this was helpful. I had a lot of fun testing all of these out. I wanted to do this for a long time. If I haven't talked about a case that you want me to evaluate somehow, you can put it in the notes. If I know anything about the case, I'll talk about it. Otherwise, I won't. But anyway, it was great doing this. Thank you so much for watching. I hope it was helpful. Bye.